Peragus here, and welcome to an episode of Space Engineers. This episode will take a look at another long conveyor mod by Katarina and Kasani. Or Kasani. How do you pronounce that? As well as the ship closet, which is still a work in progress by Sherbert. Which, that mod is something I kind of missed. Because it's a very useful and interesting mod, which actually helps solve a lot of problems. A few problems I've had myself. Yeah, still a work in progress, so it's still got things that need to be worked out on it. But it is actually a very useful mod. But first, let's take a pokey at the conveyors. Pretty much the same things last time. But different styles. So first person. So you can see here, we have all the conveyors. Well, you know, got the regular conveyor, the normal vanilla, as well as the encased ones. You got the 5 block pipes, then you got the 9 block pipes, then you got the 15 block pipes, and then the 21 block pipes. And apart from being incredibly long, they function the same as any other conveyor. So this will help you save on your PCU so that your computer or server will run faster. It'll help on the simulation speed. And I do believe it's the same build cost as the other pipes. Well, the ratio. Pretty much uses the exact same number of items as it would do if you place down an equal number of single blocked versions. Yeah. It seems to be the case. And just use up the same amount of materials. That's all we can do with that one. Nothing else to it. So let's take a look at the more interesting mod. The ship closet. And you see, it's just a simple 3x3x1 block with a panel in the middle. And it has a bit of a rotating disc. And also colour to it. Now you can see at the moment, my car is currently a ghost. Apart from the wheels. Well, that's fucking weird. Because this, at the moment, my car is stored inside the block. And how do you get it out? Well, I click on unload. Well then, I think the wheels came off. Oh. Yeah, it's green when it's ready. I need to check something. Oh my. So yeah, it's still a work in progress, so something like that is to be expected. So it has lost its wheels. So if you put any ship on there that's a multi-grid, you're getting double there. Problems like this. Only the primary grid will get saved. The subgrids, they won't. And you can tell when it's saved is when it's in that little ghost form. I need to delete these wheels now, aren't I? Nee. So yeah, it's best for just small ships that doesn't have any extra grids to it. Yeah. When in the G menu, you select it, you go to load and unload, put them on there. With the load, putting the ship into the block, thus allowing you to more easily fly around without needing to properly secure it. So I do believe that won't fall off if it ends up upside down. Thus it means your ships will be a lot safer, especially when you're going to jump across a large area. You don't have to make sure it's attached by a connector. It unloads to gain access to it again. But again, don't use anything with subgrids. Otherwise, you're going to end up with the subgrids missing. bit of a shame, but oh well. It's one of the limitations it has at the moment. And I'm pretty sure as the modder, Sherbert, continues working on it, he'll be able to get the subgrids to also be saved. So you won't end up with this sort of situation. I just think it's a really good mod for storing your ships and buggering off with them. Oh yeah, and it can only load one ship. So you need one of these pads for every single ship you wish to store in your hangar. Which I think is quite useful. So anyway, as for the build cost, quite expensive. You need 200 interior plates, 100 construction components, 150 computers, 100 superconductors, 20 detector components, 75 metal grids, and 200 steel plates. Which, expensive, but worth it considering what it can do. Keep your ship safe as you travel throughout the universe and on planets and stuff like that. I'm just really annoyed that the wheels are gone. Because of how I designed this vehicle, those wheels are going to be a real pain in the ass to get back on. Oh well, never mind. It'll be fine. And that's it. Can you recolor this thing? Make it to mesh in with your designs a bit better. Let's go for the red disco. Alright. Oh, there we go. Wonder why the skin wasn't working then. So yeah, you can reskin and colour it as well. Oh, change the colour of the pad. Don't change the skin of the pad, but the colour it does. Still has the green when it's ready to save a ship, and blue when it has a ship saved. Debunk. So yeah, load puts it into it, so it's ready. Unload brings it out so you can use it. And that's all there really is to say about this thing. Hopefully, in the future, when Sherbert works on some more, subgrids will also get saved. So anyway, I will have links for both of these mods in the description below. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for more episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.